Welcome to Project Pro Code Recipes. In this video, we are going to learn on how to create your own simulated data for regression in Python. So this is the code snippet. I have copied this code and I pasted that in my Jupyter notebook. I'll explain to you the code over here as well as run this for you. So let's get started. Now what? So we all are familiar with two types of problem that is generally dealt in that we generally deal in. Data analysis. So one is regression type and the other is classification type. So classification, classification means to classify something. For example, whether you can classify an apple into a fruit or vegetable, this is a type of classification problem. Whereas regression deals with continuous values. So basically, when you are predicting sales for a store, this comes under regression. Now sklearn is a very powerful library which is preloaded with data sets such as Boston data set, Iris data set. You can visit our YouTube channel for videos like this in which I have explained on how to load these preloaded data sets of sklearn. But in this video we are going to understand on how to make regression, how to make your own data sets using sklearn. So let's get started now. So I've defined my function over here. Now these are two general print statements. I've loaded my pandas library to convert my numpy array into data frame. Now from sklearn.data sets, import make regression. If I wanted to make a classification data set, I would have used make underscore classification. Now make regression n samples equal to 100, that is I want 100 samples. N features, I want 3 features, n informative, all the 3 should be informative. If I pass n informative equal to 2 and and I think one more parameter is and one more feature is I think n dependent, that is 1. So this means this n dependent will depend upon the 2 informative features. That is, it is going to be the linear combination of the 2 features which is redundant to me. So basically, if I want to generate any redundant feature, I will use that. Now n targets equal to 1, that is I want only 1 output target. Noise, Gaussian noise. So basically noise over here refers to Gaussian noise, so I don't want any Gaussian noise. Coefficient equal to true, that is this means also give me the coefficient. So what is the coefficient that we are talking about? Now this make regression must be using something or some method to generate the data points. So basically it uses a linear regression model too, a random selected linear regression model. So I want the coefficients of the model that it has used to generate this point. Now this coefficient, okay, is generated under this. Now this output is given, is saved under this, and feature is saved under this. These all are NumPy matrix, so I need to convert them into data frame. So while printing statements, I am converting them into data frame. So pd.dataframe is the function that I am using, and that actually we need to use in convert to a NumPy array into a data frame. Feature is the feature matrix you need to pass, and in columns you need to pass the column name. So here I am using 3 features. So I pass the column name as feature 1, feature 2, and feature 3. Dot head prints the first 5 rows for me. The same goes for the output. NumPy array. So pd.dataframe output columns is equal to target. Now this I have done the same for coefficient. So pd.dataframe coefficient columns equal to true coefficient values. Now these are the features. This is my target column and this is my true coefficient values. Now this was all about codes in this video. For more industry relevant projects, you can visit our website. You can also visit our website for more code recipes like this, and also our YouTube channel. You can get your customized code in case you don't find it on our website by using this click here function. You just need to submit your request. So thank you, and the URL for these video will be available in the link below.